Intensifying violence between Taliban, ISK heralds new war in Afghanistan. When the last US soldiers left Afghanistan on August 31, the Taliban triumphantly declared an end to the two-decade war in Afghanistan. The Western-backed Afghan government had collapsed, the Taliban captured the capital, Kabul, and many Afghans expected the hardline militants to restore order. But the Taliban's intensifying rivalry with the Islamic State Khorasan, ISK, a rival militant group, has signaled the beginning of another phase of war in Afghanistan, a development that many Afghans dread will provoke further bloodshed. Every day, two or three people are killed, Abdullah, a resident of the eastern province of Nangarhar, a stronghold of ISK, told RFERL's Radio Azadi. Abdullah said ISK bomb attacks and assassinations have increased since the Taliban seized control of Afghanistan on August 15. "People here are perplexed," said Abdullah, who did not reveal his real name for fear of reprisals. ISK, he added, was very weak under the previous government but is now experiencing a revival. There has been a surge in ISK attacks against the Taliban and Afghan civilians in the past 2 months. Experts say the extremist group has been bolstered by the diminished US counterterrorism presence in Afghanistan and the Taliban's inadvertent release of hundreds of ISK inmates from prisons during its sweep of the country. An ISK suicide bomber blew himself up inside a Shiite mosque in the northern province of Kunduz on October 8, killing more than 70 people and injuring over 140. It was the deadliest attack since the international troop withdrawal. The Taliban has tried to downplay the threat posed by ISK, vowing to eliminate the group. But communities caught in the middle of the intensifying war between the Taliban and ISK said they fear more violence.